hope you've all had a good week, and this week we've got Sylvaneth Take 2. It's a Battletome preview, so I hope you will sit back and enjoy the video. But before I carry on, please like and subscribe to the channel. It means so much to us. So, without further ado, grab a cup of tea and let's see what Sylvaneth are bringing to the table in the upcoming weeks. Right then, everyone, first up, we're going to look at some tweaks to the army. First of all, they are a couple of new unit roles. They've also changed the options on some units, and they've also changed around the points a bit. So let's have a look at the first one. First up, we're looking at the Tree Revenants and their wave pipes. So it now reads, 1 in 5 models in this unit can carry wave pipes. At the start of the movement phase, that unit can include wave pipes, can walk the spirit path instead of making a normal move. If it does so, remove the unit from the battlefield, set up anywhere on the battlefield more than 9 inches away from enemy units. So, effectively, Tree Revenants can choose to teleport, whether it's like getting them out of trouble, whether it's closer to an objective, or it's just to realign and give support to other units. To me, that's an amazing buff. So, you know, I think we're going to see a lot of Tree Revenants out. But I like the look of a Tree Revenant anyway, so, you know, that's one buff that we can have a look at. And we've got a few more, so. And next up, guys, we've got some more changes to the Draker Hammerdreth, where we had to pick a role for this model. It was, you either chose between the Flutter Fairy, the Flutter Flurries, or the Squirmlings. They've said rather than choose either or now, it's you have both. So you can change it on the fly. It's a Swiss Army knife, now. So as you see on the screen, I've added, at the start of the battle round, declare whether this model is enraged or embittered. The Revenant's abilities below last until the end of the battle round. If he's enraged, one of the models enraged the colony of Flutter Flurries has an attack characteristic of 20 instead of 10. While this model is embittered, Swarm of Squirmlings have an attack characteristic of 20 instead of 10. So, whether you want a ranged attack or you want to be up close and personal, it's up to you. And thankfully, you can change that now on the fly. So it's as and when needed. So good job, GW. You listen to your audience on that one. Right then, guys, next change we got, and this is going to be the last tweak that I'm going to go over, is for the Tree Lords. So we've covered your normal line troops, we've chosen your specials, and we've got, you know, a big guy as well. So, Tree Lords, I'm going to come with Ground Shaking Stomp. They've refined it a little bit. They've changed it to, as it is on the screen, at the start of the combat phase, pick one enemy unit within 3 inches of this model and roll a dice on the 4+, that unit fights at the end of the combat phase after the players pick other units to fight. So 4+ to stop your opponent going first, that's a win-win for me. That's, you want these guys hitting at full strength, that's one way of getting it done. I'm going to go over some lore that they got as well, because we're going to be going over the lore of the Deepwood as well, which will help these as well, so just bear that in mind. So I tell you what, let's have a look at that now, the Lord of the Deepwoods. Right then, guys, we are looking at the Lord of the Deepwoods now, which you would need a Branch Witch for, and possibly another model, but they've mentioned Branch Witch and Allegria herself, so we're just going to go with that. So here we go. First up on the the low is Boudreaux Army. It's cast value of 7. If successful, pick one friendly Sylvaneth unit wholly within 18 inches of the caster and visible to them. You can return one same model to that unit. If you picked a unit of Dryads, Tree Revenants, or Spike Revenants, you can return up to D3 slain models from that unit instead of one. So, that's a nice little buff. Granted, you're using up a spell to do it, but if you need to keep that unit, you know, tied up, and you've got your Tree Revenants and your Spike Revenants there, you can bring them back if you're lucky enough. But I can see this lore is a lot of it's a wounds negator that it is, and it's buffing your wounds counter it is. So let's have a look at another one, is it? Because that is amazing. And like I said, it's D3, it's not gonna be a guaranteed 3 every time, but what can I say? It's nice when you need the models. Right then guys, we've looked at the chaff of your army, your troopers, but say they're okay, they are, you know, they're covering ground, doing well, but your big guy, your tree lord is, you know, he's feeling quite boisterous, and he squares up to, say, Scarbrand. Some of you are going to say it's not fair, he's going to take quite a few wounds before, you know, he can do anything. This is the spell that's going to help you. It's called Regrowth. Regrowth has a casting value of 5. So you can do this on one dice easily. So two dice. I'm sure this one's going to go off more often than not. If successful, you pick one friendly Sylvaneth unit wholly within 18 inches of the caster and visible to them. Heal up to D6 wounds allocated to them. So your multi-wound guys that you want to keep in the fight, you want them to like wreck face, you need them to charge in, you know, kick ass, take names afterwards. This is your spell that you just keep buffing them. But it's not just a buffing lore. Like, we all know that it can summon wild woods, so it gives you maneuverability, it gives you cover, but it's got quite good synergy when you add command trait and, you know, the unit's abilities themselves. So like your tree lords are going to be, you know, when you put them with their own like armies, like what they call glades in this, and you, like I said earlier, you've got the stomp that stops them, you know, stops your opponent attacking first. You can buff it, you're going to heal them, so they're higher up on the table. Tree lords also have an ability where they can subtract 2 from wounds taken, so they can hit harder. So if, say, you attack the tree lord, cause 2 wounds, when they come in you can subtract 2, so it's like the top of the table again, it's like they've not taken any damage. So it's like I said, that's a whole buffing combination that you can do with it, and it all works from spells like this. And there's going to be another one here that's going to help you get the harder spells off if you want to get them off early in the game, and it's called Throne of Vines. So let's have a look at Throne of Vines. And here it is, Throne of Vines. Throne of Vines is a casting value of 5, so again, quite easy. It's successful, add 2 to the casting rolls for the caster until the caster makes a move or is set in a different location, which would be, you know, the realm route way. So, if you were willing to sit him back, you put him in cover, probably of a Wildwood, because they have their own little buffs. You can spread the trees around. You can buff your army. And then when you need to, zip them along the tree line. Turns up at another spot, you can set up your throne again. Absolutely fantastic spells. These are phenomenal. If I didn't have a Patreon that despises magic in all forms, I would be impressed by this, but we abhor the witch. We abhor the witch on this channel. So I can't show a lot of appreciation here because, you know, blood for the blood god, skulls for the skull throne. And as I said earlier, when you link your command traits, when you link the artifacts, as well as you have your wildwood, you have your lore, this army comes into its own. It's a complete synergetic army. I am amazed at it because of how well it's been put together, in my opinion. And here's an example of what I'm on about. You've got a command trait and artifact here. So you've got Glade Lore. And when you're casting rolls for your general, while it is wholly within 6 inches of an awakened wildwood. So you add that to your throne of vines. You may as well just be rolling a 2 the whole time. And that makes it easier then for when you're rolling your higher spell. So your 7s become 5s and everything when you're throwing the wildwood. And you've got the glade lore. But on top of that, if you've read ahead of me, we've got the lamp. Add 2 to rolls when the bearer attempts to unbind or dispel an endless spell. So these are magic nullifiers. These are like, you come into the woods, you're in for a big surprise because you ain't doing anything with your magic. It is amazing. It's really shocking, I gotta be honest, because, you know, I would have expected, you know, this type of thing from, let's be honest, Stormcast. The poster boys and things, you would have thought they had that, but Sylvaneth, they're just blowing everybody out of the water, but yeah, especially in our magic phase, it's phenomenal. So we've had a quick look at the lore, we've had a look at artifacts and a quick look at the trait. As you can see, we've got glades mentioned. Glades are going to be the armies for Sylvaneth. So let's have a quick look at an example of what you could have for your glade. And here we go, guys. We're going to have 2 examples of glades. So in the book, there's going to be 7 glades for your army. So I got 2 examples here. One is a dreadwood and one is a heartwood. So it's all how you want to build your army, which Age of Sigma does fantastically. How you want to build your army is up to you, but they've covered everything. So first off, it looks like we've got the dreadwood, which favors spite revenants. So it's possibly a in your face, rip you apart type of army. So it's going to be malicious tormentors. You can reroll hit for of ones made by the dreadwood spite revenants. So as we know, is when you got your law, when you got your branch witch behind them and they're running in, you might lose a few. If your branch witch has got, you know, throne of vines or is close to a wildwood, easily it's gonna be buffing this unit. It's gonna be bringing 1 or 2 back. You know, so it's a lot to think about. It's a lot of options and a lot of synergies. So this looks like the hard hitters of the group, you know, the in your face smash and grab. But let's look at a different example of a glade. And here's the second example. It's called the heartwood. So it looks like this is more, you know, a well-rounded army. This is probably going to be the, you know, the shining example of what a Sylvaneth army is. And that it's got an artifact called the Horn of Concert. You can re-roll hit rolls attacked by made by friendly heartwood Kurnoth hunters when they're within 12 inches of the bearer. Now Kurnoth hunters are fantastic, especially, you know, if you want to protect an objective and if you've got some wildwoods around, they're going to be zipping around the routes. So they are phenomenal. It's going to be an amazing army. And I've been saying about zipping around the realm routes and all that now, But I've not given you an example yet. So let's finish up with how the rules for navigating realm routes are. So you can see how you're going to get the best out of your teleporting tree men. Right then, guys, here we got the navigate realm route. Instead of making a normal move in the movement phase, one friendly Sylvaneth unit wholly within 6 inches of a wildwood can navigate the realm route. If it does so, remove that unit from the battlefield and then set it up wholly within 6 inches of another wildwood but more than 9 inches from an enemy unit. So effectively, the more trees you've got on the board, and I hate to say it because I don't like it when this is spammed, the wildwood, but effectively you can cover your objectives, you can support, say, your revenants with Kunoth hunters. There is a variety of things you can do with this. Tomorrow's video we'd be going over the wildwoods and what you can do, because I've got a few things I want to say about it, but I want to organize what I want to say as well, so I'm going to go over it tomorrow. But it looks like this army covers everything. You've got very strong magic, you've got a buff magic, which is, you know, which is cracking, because you can heal wounds, you can add slain models, you know, it's covering all the bases. And then on top of that, they've tweaked some of the rules now to make it easier, and they hit hard, and you know when they attack you, it's more than just a splinter in your finger, there's probably a splinter or two stuck right up your ass crack with these guys. So they are amazing. We went over a few models in previous videos, I think that was about a month ago now because of the delay, and yeah, it's quite a synergistic army, and I can't wait to see how they change the meta, because I got a feeling the Heartwood Sylvaneth army is going to be quite a powerful army, and we might see it shift the meta about. But you know, that's my opinion. If you guys have got a different opinion, let me know. That's what the comment section is there for. And that's it, guys. Thank you for sticking with me through the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, please like the video. It means so much to the channel. There's going to be more content coming up in future videos. I'm going to try and get back to my 2-3 video release a week. We will be bringing back the Blood Bowl videos because we'll be starting the league. And I hopefully going to be starting up doing some Blood Bowl gaming as well. So you might see the noob with the game. So you'll be seeing me failing Blood Bowl, especially with the Halfling team. So all fun and games. But anyway, guys, that's going to be in the future. At the present, I want to say thank you, and please subscribe if you're not a subscriber. If you are a subscriber, share it amongst your friends. It means so much, because it doesn't mean that we get lost in the echo with all the bigger channels. It's we can be able to stand out on our own. And until tomorrow, guys, until the next video, I shall see you again. Enjoy.